Hey guys, what's going on? So I'm gonna do an airbrush demo, doing a tire cover, incorporating vinyl masking into this. So I had a customer come before the pandemic and dropped off a couple tire covers. I'm doing two different ones. One I'm gonna do tonight, the other one I'll probably do tomorrow. This one is a thin red line flag, but we're incorporating the fireman's axe. And it's for Devin Finneran. He died in 2020. I didn't get the whole specifics, but that's the theme of the design. I'll go over a little bit of how I treated the vinyl. So for prep, I used SEM 38354 plastic and leather prep. So I used that. I wiped it down, getting off any grease, any wax, any fingerprints, any oils, or anything like that. So that's my prep. All right, so what I'm going to start off with, I have ETAC's opaque white, which is their titanium white. So I'm going to use that as my base. Sorry for the compressor noise. Okay, so now when painting tire covers, you don't want to flood the paint on too heavy. So I'm going to come in with a hairdryer. So now I'm going to do that a couple of times until I get the opacity that I want, because I want the flag to be white. I'm going to make the axe red, okay? So I'm going to keep building up with the white first. Okay, so now that I got my white base down on this, I have a secondary template that I'm putting in there, which has got the fireman's cross. So I'm going to add that up into the axe, because that was a part of the design. I had to do it in two parts. So now I have my secondary template in place. Now I'm going to paint the axe red, but I'm going to mask off the outer layers of white so I don't sit there and have to paint it again. Okay, the masking tape that I'm using is just what we call transfer tape or R tape. It's used in the industry for transferring vinyls, masking off goalie masks, masking off metal art. All depends on what you're looking for. It's a low-tack application tape, which is great. It comes in several different widths. I think I have about a 6-inch width roll here that I'm using. This is called Spectrum. There's different brands out on the market. Hey guys, for anybody coming in, you don't know what I'm doing, I'm painting a tire cover. taking another finger, got that all masked off. Okay, now for the next step, I'm gonna paint red. Okay, so that part's done. I noticed one little touch-up spot. One little one is good. I'll take that over a bunch. Now, I could have done this design freehand, but it'll be it's a lot cleaner. Taking the image that the customer provided, making a vector file out of it in Illustrator, and then running it through my 24-inch Roland GX24 plotter. If you have access to a plotter or can afford one, it's definitely worth your while. Okay, I'll give you a little peek at that. So that was the secondary mask that I added in over the white base and then painted it red. Okay, now let's see the magic happen when I remove the full mask, and then you can see the flag on the black background of the tire cover. If I actually did this video from start to finish with all the masking, it probably would have taken about 2 hours. So I wanted to save you all the mundane taping and masking and everything else. I just want to get straight to painting so everybody could see the process. Well, let's see how it looks. Hi guys, that's pretty much it. There's a couple of touch-ups I didn't notice, but I'm not gonna put you through that. So you can see what it looks like. Hi guys, have a good night. I'll see you for the next one.